Hello and welcome to my channel. Today's video is going to be about how to create polygon backgrounds like this one. Let's open a new file and let's go to File, New. You can open files of any size. I'll just choose 18x8 inches and CMYK color. Click Create. Now we're going to start making our polygons, but before that we need to have a color palette ready. One of the methods to get your color palette is to go to Adobe Color and you can choose some color palette from there. Or the second option is to create your own palette using the blend tool in Illustrator. If you don't know how to do that, you can go ahead and check out my video, which I'll post a link somewhere over here. I have already selected my color palette, so I'm just going to paste it here. This is something which I created using Adobe Blend Tool. With the Blend Tool, you just need the darkest color and the lightest color, and then you can create colors in between. I've created 5 colors in between. You can choose your palette to be much bigger with 10 colors or even smaller with 3 or 4 colors. Now we can start making our polygons. For this tutorial, I'm using a pen tool. You can also use your line tool, but it's much easier, convenient, and pretty fast if you use the pen tool. Go ahead and click on the pen tool, or you can also press P on your keyboard to select the pen tool. Once you have the pen tool ready, we're going to start making triangles. And these triangles need not be uniform. So let's just make a triangle. With the pen tool, when you click and drag, you see these handles. So we want to make sure that we don't need these handles at all. So your task for this is just to click. Let me undo that. So all you have to do is click, go to a place, click again, come back, click, go and join the first anchor point. So now your triangle is complete. So now you have to choose a color for your triangle. You have white selected, but we want it to be one of these colors. So all you have to do is press I on your keyboard, or you can also go to your eyedropper tool right here. Go ahead and select one color. Now I'll press P on my keyboard to go back to pen tool. So you don't have to do this like after each triangle. You can make all your triangles, finish off the whole design, and then go choose colors as well. So let's go ahead and make a different triangle. So I'm going to show you something. This triangle is selected. So if you hover next to the anchor point, you see a minus sign next to your pen tool. That means that if you click on it, it's going to disappear. So let me undo that. Command Z or Control Z. So we don't want that to happen. So what we're going to do is you have to unselect this triangle before clicking on your pen tool. All you have to do is go to your selection tool, click outside, and go ahead and take the pen tool. And one more point. I have disabled the stroke color. It would be better if you do that. Okay, going back to the pen tool. Now we're going to draw our next triangle. So click, 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 and then go back and make sure you click the first anchor point, otherwise your triangle is not complete. So I'll just select some color so that we can see our pretty triangle. P for the pen tool. But before that, click outside. P. Let's make the last triangle right here. Click, click, and join. Let's make this a little lighter. Maybe like this. Okay, so we're going to keep on drawing triangles. So this is how we're going to go ahead and finish off our whole pattern. So I'll come back after finishing the whole pattern. One thing to note, try to make your triangles thinner. They shouldn't be very uniform because they don't look that nice when you want to do that. But unless your design really calls for it, or try to make them non-uniform. They look better that way. And also make sure your guidelines are on so that when you click and drag and try to make a line out of it, you can pretty much see where your, you know, points are, etc., etc. So make sure your guidelines are turned on for better results. Okay, so we have our polygon design ready. Now, all you have to do is export it. And to export it, let's just place this here. You don't have to delete it or anything. You can still keep it like this. So all you have to do is go to File, Export, Export As. Make sure it's selected as PNG and say click on Use Artboards. This is really important. So click on Use Artboards and say Export. So when you do that, the region within this artboard gets selected, and then you have a very nice PNG which gets exported. Let's go ahead and take a look at it. So this is how our pattern looks like right now. You can make a lot of modifications to this pattern. For example, you could make the triangles thicker, more uniform, isosceles triangles. You can even make squares or, you know, rectangles but shaped in different formats. Possibilities are endless. You can also make different types of color patterns in this. For example, I'll show you. This is a pink. This is something which I created before this. So this is the same color pattern that I used, but you could make something like in blue, or you can make, this one has more uniform triangles or more fatter triangles, and this is how it'll look like. But one thing is, I haven't used any whites in here. So maybe if you use whites or more contrasting colors, it'll pop up something like this. And this is something where I've used contrasting colors. I took a palette, color palette from Adobe Color, and tried to put in different colors over here so that it looks a little different compared to this one. It's the same pattern, I mean, the design, by the way. You have one more thing, that is applying the shadows, which gives like a folded paper effect. And you can do this very easily. Let me just quickly show you how to do that. So all you have to do is just click and drag and select everything. Make sure you're in your selection tool. And then go to Effect, Stylize, Drop Shadow. Make sure your preview is checked. And now you can see I've kept mode in luminosity, opacity at 75%, X offset is 0.1, 0.1, and blur is 0.1, and this I've kept at color and black. Click OK. Click outside, and you can see this paper folding effect on your, or the origami effect on your pattern as well. Undo that because I don't want it. The last one is random shapes. This is not a triangle, but I was just trying to experiment with different kind of shapes. Yeah, so this is basically how you create a polygon pattern using your simple pen tool and your blend tool to choose colors. I hope you liked this video, and if you did, please give me a thumbs up. You can also subscribe to my channel. You can go ahead and check out my blog where I usually post free stuff. And if you have any question or want to learn something, just leave a comment below and I'll try to put up a video on it. Until next week, bye-bye.